It's time to enter the world of real estate in Oahu with Hawaii's only true real estate radio show, the Team Lally Real Estate Show. Grab a pen and get ready to take notes. For the next full hour, Hawaii's premier real estate leader, Adrienne Lally, and Attilio Leonardi will bring you the latest in real estate news and real-world strategies on how they can guarantee to sell your home at a price and deadline you agree to, or they'll buy it. Now, here are your hosts, Adrienne and Attilio.
Welcome to the Team Lally Real Estate Show, home in the Guaranteed Sold program, or we'll buy it. If you have any questions, just give us a call at 799-9596 or check us out online at teamlally.com.
Well, hey, everybody, this is Attilio, and this is the part of the show where we talk about art. And Adrienne, what is that art? It's an acronym. What's it stand for?
It stands for Attilio's Random Thoughts.
And they're anything but random because I am constantly in a state of growth and learning and looking for things to bring to our listeners that I hope will, if you execute on this information I'm sharing with you, you know, make either a better version of you and or maybe bring some improvement into your life and the people that are around you.
So what kind of art do you have for us this week, Attilio?
Yeah, so I want to go back to it's an oldie but a goodie, and it's a guy named David Kiyosaki. Who's that?
He is Rich Dad, Poor Dad.
Well, first of all, here's a tip for you guys. If you want to really get to know something, teach it.
Yes.
Teach it more and more. Talk about it.
Internalize it.
Yeah, internalize it, and how we internalize it. You guarantee that you're going to know a topic if you teach on it, talk about it on a radio show, whatever it is that may be. So here's what I want to talk about, Rich Dad, Poor Dad. And Adrienne, I know you may or may not know this all on top of your head. I've been talking about it with my kids. I've been talking about it with other people. I've been studying it. So it is top of mind for me. But it's good for me to ask you questions because it's more interesting than me just vomiting this stuff on people. Let's have a dialogue versus a monologue. So David Kiyosaki has what we call the cash flow quadrant. This is something good for everybody to be reminded of coming the beginning of the year. We want to make a new change. We want to pivot. We are coming. Folks, it's going to be okay. Pandemic, we are coming out of it. We got vaccines. We got protocols in place. Hotels are opening up. Waikiki is opening up. Folks, it's going to be okay. All right, take a deep breath. Namaste. Everything gonna be okay. All right, so cash flow.
I feel better already.
Cash flow quadrant. You know, this is something that existed pre-COVID. It's existed during the pandemic, and it's going to exist long after we are all vaccinated and maybe not wearing masks anymore. But I think masks are cool. Especially if you're just, you know, in a sour mood, and I can't
tell. Or if you have bad breath, or if you have crooked teeth.
Yeah.
Or, you know, if you just have the RBF, you just don't know.
Maybe you want to have a message. You know, I like my, Adrienne got me some masks. It says, be kind.
Yes.
I just look at people.
And they smile.
With my mask. With my mask, it says, be kind.
That's right.
So, cash flow quadrant. Quadrant infers that there are four parts to it. So just imagine, draw a line down the middle, draw a line horizontal across the piece of paper, divide it into four sections. And we're going to talk about typically how wealth is built or not built in this country, on this planet, based on what David Kiyosaki has talked about in his book. What's the name of the book?
It's Rich Dad, Poor Dad.
Rich Dad, Poor Dad. So he has the four cash flow quadrants. And Adrienne, do you remember on the left side where 90% of the people are? What are the two?
I believe it's an employee.
Employee.
And then self-employed.
Self-employed. Now, there's a difference between a business owner versus a business operator or somebody that's self-employed. Here's the difference. If you are self-employed, that means you go to work every day. Let's say you bought like a Subway sandwich shop. Franchise, you got to go there. You don't quite have enough business or volume or enough employees where you don't have to show up for work. So we call that, what do we call it?
You call that owning a job. You own your job.
Owning a job or buying a job. You know, if you're looking at a franchise, you're buying a job. Hopefully, you're going to transition to the point where you have employees and you have leverage and things are taken care of. So employee, self-employed, is on the left two quadrants. 90% of people in the United States are either working for somebody or they work directly in their own business in the United States. Those are the statistics. Something interesting, less than 10% of the wealth in the United States is controlled by 90% of you who have a job or own a job.
Mm-hmm.
All right, other side of the vertical axis, or the top right quadrant and the top bottom quadrant, what are those two?
That is, yes, that would be a business owner and then the investor.
The investor. Good job, Adrian.
Yes.
She remembered all of this. She didn't even study up on it. She just knew it. So business owner would be someone that has a business that you receive passive income from, or what we call mailbox money. This is money that comes to you because you own the business, you don't work directly in it, and whether you're feeling sick, whether you got COVID, whether you're on vacation, whether you're being like James Bond and you're in the casinos in Monaco, going up and ordering a martini, shaken but not stirred, the money comes in. Now, that's a business. Mm-hmm. It's an income stream. Investor, where's the income coming from for investors?
That would be from... that would be like passive income. So, for example, hopefully we'll get Kyle on the line today, and he'll talk a little bit about the investing strategies that you can do through a DST. So I have a DST, and that money just shows up in my account every month, and I don't have any, there's no worries. There's no stress.
We'll get into the details later with Kyle, and if not, I'll cover it, because I took good notes on the class yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
But basically, give the people the simple math. You invested how much money, and how much money do you get a month?
So I invested $100,000 through a 1031 exchange.
Where'd that money come from?
I sold a condo in Florida that I've owned for about 20 years, and the proceeds, which was $100,000, was 1031 exchanged into a DST. So now I get $500 every month that just shows up in my account by the 5th of the month.
Oh, by the way, Adrian, Shira says, yeah! She used to work for Yahoo, so she left off the who part, so she Anyway.
So speaking of business owners and investors, we have Duke Kim Han of Hawaii Pacific Property Management calling in with his tip of the week.
Hey, Duke.
Hey, hi. I'm in Las Vegas right now, so
nice.
My tip may be a little bit twisted.
All
I'm
right.
Joking.
Give us the twisted tip of the week.
What are the odds on your twist? What's the bookie odds?
Yeah. So one of the things that I sent the video out this week was, I have many owners who have older houses that have a back room or a rental, and they try to include water and electric in rent. It's always a bad idea, because people who have water and electric included usually take advantage of that. And let me give you an example. We had a home that had a back rental in it, like a mother-in-law quarters, and he had his own washer and dryer. So he was bringing home all the towels from his workplace to wash, and he was charging the workplace per towel to do it. And, of course, the owner ran up electric and water to the tune of $800 a month extra.
Wow. That's interesting.
Yes. So he also didn't do house rules. So I always say include house rules to say what the limit is that they can use on each of those utilities. And we've been having a whole lot of trouble with owners who try to save a little bit of money, who try to make the tenants do lawn work, do landscaping. So we've just been in a legal fight, with two tenants who just totally let the yards go. So we got quotes on landscaping to redo the lawns and the trees and the shrubs, and all of them were over $1,000.
Yeah, so landscaping is expensive.
But it's a big part of your curb appeal to your house and your value. So why would the owners leave that to a tenant to do? Tenants come in two modes: love lawn work, hate lawn work. 75% of the time, you're going to get a tenant who just hates lawn work but wanted to save money because he got a cheaper rent. So he'd go out there every 2 months and mow the lawn and trim the trees, if that. And when they take off, they know they're leaving, they don't do any lawn work.
So, Duke, what is your guys' policy on this now with all these issues that you've been coming across?
So we tell owners that we will not manage their properties unless they include lawn service.
Professional landscaping.
It's just, it's too hard to fight, and basically we're going to lose.
Yeah.
You're going to lose on carpet, and you're going to lose on landscape. So people that have carpet, we're going to get into a fight with them, and we're going to go to court. There's going to be legal fees. It's just not worth it.
So two hot buttons, landscaping and carpets.
Tenants taking care of the landscaping is like having a chocolate cake in your refrigerator and swearing you're not going to eat it. You're going to eat it! and the tenants ain't going to do the landscaping.
No.
It's rare. So there have been cases where we've had tenants who've done a great job with the lawn. But I will tell you that the amount of sleep that the owner and the property manager will lose over landscaping is not worth it. So unfortunately, you know, I just won't take owners that have that kind of decisions to make.
So do you have any tips for any homeowners, like as far as the type of landscaping? I know that you have a opinion about the kind of flooring, right, to keep, you know, the problems to a minimum. How about the landscaping? What should they be putting in their yard?
A lot of owners who have had rentals for a long time try to minimize the amount of grass they have, because grass takes two things. It takes water, and it takes somebody to cut it. So if you have less grass, you have less maintenance. And then you can send a yard guy out there once a month or once every 2 months just to spray for the weeds. It's just so much easier. So here, my house in Vegas doesn't have any grass. We don't have any problems with landscape. I send my lawn guy there once every quarter to just spray for weeds.
So low maintenance. Yard.
But, you know, there's people here that love grass, so they get grass in the yard. You got to pour all that extra water in it. You got to get somebody to come and cut it.
So, you know, even in Hawaii, in some of the Eva Plain areas where it's very arid, you're spending a lot of money on water, even if we are in Hawaii.
And if you're in an HOA, you have rules to follow. Your landscape cannot exceed this. You only can plant certain plants here. You cannot do this, and you have to do that. So, you know, we get fines on some of that stuff. Tenants refuse to pay them. So we go back to the owner. We say, hey, Mr. Owner, we told you about this. So now we're in this predicament.
And a professional landscaper, if you get a notice from the association, you can at least get a hold of them and then get out there. Tenants are going to be like, it's not my problem.
Life is too short. So, anyway, if you want professional opinions, call me. If you don't want professional opinions, don't call me.
Keep it simple. Keep it simple.
Keep it simple. Thank you, dude.
Some people want professional opinions, and they call me, and they don't do what I say. So then they wind up in this position.
Awesome.
Well, thank you, Duke.
Anyway.
Always wise advice. Bye-bye. All right.
Enjoy.
So you can get a hold of Duke and his team at 445-9223. That's 445-9223. Check them out online at hipacificpm.com. Next up, we have Kyle Shimoda of Impact Wealth Solutions. Kyle, what do you have for us this week?
Aloha.
Hey, Kyle, before we get started, I want to update my little tagline here at the bottom. What's the best number to reach you guys at?
For us, 784-4000.
4000. Ooh, like it. Easy 784-4000.
Yes.
784-4000.
So before you came on, Kyle, we were actually talking about the cash flow quadrant and Robert Kiyosaki. And I identified that you helped me to get into the, more of the investor quadrant with this DST strategy that you have. So maybe you could quickly touch on that.
Well, I also like to say one of Robert Kiyosaki's nephews actually is a wealth advisor with Impact Wealth Solutions.
So,
we know all about that book.
Yeah. Oh, wow. I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, Jason Kiyosaki is one of our advisors.
Cool.
So you have the nephew. Well, I think it's the nephew of the son of the poor dad. Because I think Kiyosaki, his dad was the poor dad, right?
Kiyosaki's dad, his actual dad was the poor dad, correct?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And then his uncle was the rich dad. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So DST, Delaware Statutory Trust.
Yes, the Delaware Statutory Trust is a fractional ownership into institutional-grade commercial property. So, so talking about getting into that investor quadrant where you put your money somewhere and you get the passive income with little or no management completely. I think many times, myself included, I have properties, and for the most part, it's passive income, yet I get those calls to, mm-hmm. you know, fix something, or, hey, tenant was going to move out, and there is still some work involved, and so it's not truly 100% passive. For a DST, you sell a property, you 1031 exchange into a Delaware Statutory Trust. In these trusts, there's properties like Walmart. There could be an Amazon distribution center. It might be a commercial property. It could be a medical facility. And you get that ongoing revenue stream when the tenants pay their rent, and then you receive the income stream. And it's managed professionally by a real estate company, so it's completely hands-off.
Now, I was super excited when I sold my rental property. It was actually excellent timing. It happened in January, right before COVID, and you helped me to get into a storage facility. So, mm-hmm. you know, I know that there's been some moratoriums on evictions and, you know, tenants that haven't been able to pay rent. So it's been a little bit of a mess, especially here in Hawaii. So I don't know. I felt like the timing of everything for my personal situation was excellent.
Yes, and actually, you know, when you think about in America, we're a consumer culture. We buy things, mm-hmm. we keep it, we store it. So yeah, your specific DST and self-storage is great,
yep.
right? And people can still afford that $50 to $200 a month payment. Right, and we like that type of asset because there's likely going to be growth in that area moving forward. So,
all right. So, if we do have your number as 734-4000.
If you 784.
Wait, 784.
Oh, sorry, 784-4000.
4000.
Yep. Yeah. And if any of our listeners want to learn more about the DST, you can go to our website at teamlally.com/DST. And Kyle and his team, we're going to be hosting webinars every month and could even set up a one-on-one meeting with Kyle and his team.
Could do a one-on-one meeting. I'm sure they could set up something. You know, if you're an employer out there and you want to, you know, I don't know, have some financial planners come in and talk to the people. Now's a good time of the year, right? Everybody's reorganizing their finances, mm-hmm. setting new goals. This would be a good time.
Yep. Tax strategy for 2020 and 2021. Mm-hmm. Yep. Good time.
Yeah. All right. Thanks, Al.
Thank you, Kyle.
All right. Thanks.
Yeah. So for you guys, I just want to simplify it. If you have a rental property and you want to do a 1031, the DST is a way to COVID-proof that, and what mm-hmm. I mean by that is if you do a 1031 of a in a hot market like we have right now where you make a lot of money, well, then you got to go back for IRS rules, and you have only so much time to identify the new property.
And it has to be of equal or greater value. Yep.
And you're going right back into the same competitive seller's market as a buyer.
Mm-hmm.
What you can do with the DST, I don't know about you, but I'd like to exit the residential rental market here at the top and then dump my money into, say, like an Amazon distribution center that they're building or putting together right now in Phoenix, Arizona.
Or you could, buy a less expensive property and use the leftovers or the boot and put that into the DST. But you have that as a safety net, right?
Yeah.
Just in case the ones that you didn't identify don't work out.
Here's the other thing. Let's say you want some money out of the transaction. You can do this tax-free. Mm-hmm. Again, we're not wealth advisors. We're not CPAs. We're not attorneys. We're not providing any of that advice. On a legal or licensed basis, we're providing it anecdotally.
Not even anecdotally. This is something that I personally did. So from my personal
anecdotal means, sharing a story of
from
what
you my personal your, experience.
Yeah, from your personal firsthand experience.
Okay, so speaking of personal experience with awesome professionals, we've got Bradley Maruyama from Allstate Insurance.
Hey, Bradley.
Hello there, folks.
Hello. What do you have for us this week?
Well, personal experience. I recently had a claim in one of our rentals, there was a little gap in our policies and the master policy. So I always like to talk about the condo claims. But in this specific incident, the renter left the water running.
Oh.
And it overflowed her tub and went to the below unit.
Mm-hmm.
There was no negligence on mine and my wife's stance. Therefore, our policy, our HO6 policy, does not cover the people below.
Mm-hmm.
In this case, this is when you should entice your renters to get renter's insurance, because in this case, the renter becomes negligent in not turning off the water. So because we weren't negligent and the renter was, we ended up paying for the damage done to the below unit.
Oh, no.
So to prevent this, you really want to entice your renter to have renter's insurance.
Well, I know that that Duke and his team usually, they're advocating for that consistently to, the tenants. They got to have their renter policy. So did the renter, did they forget to renew? That's a hard lesson.
Yeah, hard lesson. So they were supposed to have it. They didn't have it in place. If you are a property manager or don't have a property manager, make sure that the property manager is listed as additional interested party.
Mm-hmm.
So the property manager will get a copy of it when it does renew.
So will they also be made aware if they cancel it?
Yes, they'll get every correspondence that the homeowner gets. So if they do cancel it, there will be a piece of mail that the property manager gets that the policy has been terminated.
Oh, wow. Okay. So
yeah, so hard lesson. And,
yes.
It's embarrassing to share this on live air, but it is something that sometimes is overlooked.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes the property management company feels that we can't make it mandatory, but it could be part of the process where if you don't have it when you do apply, then
we're not renting to you.
You may not qualify for this rental. So.
Well, yes, definitely a hard lesson, and I appreciate your honesty and sharing this with our listeners, because, it can happen to anybody, even Bradley.
Yeah, insurance agent,
yeah.
And thank you for being vulnerable, because, Bradley, you're falling within the quotes of a very wise man called John Maxwell, and he was a preacher and a really world-renowned leadership coach, and he says this: if you want to impress people, tell them about your success, but if you want to impact people, tell them about your failures. So thank you for impacting people today.
Yes, we appreciate you and your sharing your story so we can all learn. We can learn from the mistakes.
Yeah.
And we won't make them.
Renter's insurance.
Thank you, Bradley. You always
thank
have
you.
Great stuff for
thank
us.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. All right, so you can get a hold of Bradley and his team at 591-8016. You can also find some more information about Bradley under our resource page at teamlally.com. We've got a nice video and just additional info from Bradley. Next up, we have Jody Tonga, the mortgage genius from Pacific Rim Mortgage. Jody, are you there?
I am.
Hello.
Hello.
How's it going?
Good. What you got for us this week?
So I just wanted to talk about the VA loan limit update.
Mm-hmm.
So up to beginning of January, we now have the 2021 loan limit. So now you can go up until $833,000 with the conforming interest rate. So there's two sets of VA interest rates.
Mm-hmm.
There's technically a jumbo and then a regular.
And what's the difference? Are they significantly different or just a little bit?
Just a little bit.
Cool.
But some people do, some people say like, oh, they want to compare.
Mm-hmm.
And then they're like, okay, let's stay under this limit, you know, because they do want to get the better rate. And especially if they're shopping in that price point where it's like, okay, let's stay under 833 that, and it's doable for them, then they're going to want to find that right property
mm-hmm.
at a slightly lower interest rate. Previously, it was in the 700. So it's a huge step up to be able to still get that absolute lowest interest rate for the VA loan.
So when they increase these limits, is it just, you know, do they take a look at what's happening in the market and then make adjustments accordingly?
Yeah.
Okay, so it goes with that median sell price that we keep seeing month over month.
Yes.
In the 800s.
And each county has their own limit.
Mm-hmm. Well, excellent news. I'm glad the VA has made that adjustment.
Me too. And then the other thing I wanted to mention is that there are some awesome avenues as well for, as long as you don't have any existing VA loans,
mm-hmm.
to do the zero down, and you can go above $2 million.
Wow.
With zero down.
That's insane.
Wow.
Yeah.
Zero down. Buy the house. We're just talking with some friends, and our friend last night, he said he had an officer bought a house in Hawaii Kai many, many years ago for, I don't know, $100,000, and fast forward to today, it's like $2.5 million. So,
yeah.
Yeah.
All right.
It's going up.
Well, so, thank you, Jody. Excellent information on the VA loan limit update. We appreciate your call in.
You're welcome. Have a good one.
All right. Thanks,
yeah,
Jody.
Yeah, I was like having Jody on the show. She makes our IQ go up because she's a market genius.
That's right. And you can get a hold of Jody and her team at 488-5510. Check them out online at PacRamMTG.com. Now, we're going to take a short break, but stay with us. We do have a special guest that's going to be joining us.
That'll change your life forever.
Well, do you have a friend who's having a hard time selling their home? Well, be a real friend to them and tell them about Adrian and Attilio, the agents who guarantee to sell their home. Anna and Aldwin needed to liquidate an investment property in Waikiki to help fund their retirement, but they were concerned about the pandemic, so they hired Adrian and Attilio. The marketing went into full gear, including the 3D interactive tours, a large social media push. And it sold for top dollar in only 6 days. Anna and Aldwin can now continue to enjoy their retirement. They are so confident in their marketing strategy. Team Lally will guarantee to sell your home at a price and deadline you agree to, or they're going to buy it. Life does happen. There's things that will come up. And if you need to get out of the contract, they'll let you out at any time. Adrian Lally, Attilio Leonardi of Team Lally Real Estate Group of Keller Williams, Honolulu. Give them a call today at 799-9596, 799-9596. You want to go online, check them out there. You can do that at teamlally.com. That's teamlally.com.
Hey, it's Sean Hannity here. And I know the business climate has changed dramatically, but if you need to sell your home, don't believe the myth that homes aren't selling. Joining me now is a true expert at selling homes, Adrian Lally and Attilio Leonardi of Team Lally Real Estate Group of Keller Williams, Honolulu. So what's your advice on selling a home right now?
Sean, our real estate team has always been on the cutting edge with technology. We're using FaceTime for showing homes with buyers and keeping our buyers and sellers safe with a virtual showing at any anytime and any place. We've sold hundreds of homes this way.
So what does that mean for sellers?
Sean, ignore the fake news. This is an incredible opportunity for sellers. Supply has plummeted. Demand has skyrocketed. People still have to move. We have thousands of motivated buyers ready to buy. We eliminate the tire kickers, conduct the virtual showing safely, quickly, and conveniently to sell their homes.
All right, thanks so much. Look, talk to the agent that I trust for the best advice. Call Team Lally now at 799-9596. Online at 808GuaranteedSale.com.
Hi, I'm Barbara Corcoran. I hope every family will stay healthy and safe during these uncertain times. Our real estate market is experiencing many challenges every day. If you're planning to move or sell your home now, be sure to get the most current information from the best agent in your marketplace. In Honolulu, you should call Adrian Lally and Attilio Leonardi. You'll need an agent who is trusted in your community and understands your needs. Go online or call, and please stay safe.
Team Lally Real Estate Show continues.
Give it to me, I'm worth it.
Welcome back, and thanks for listening to the Team Lally Real Estate Show, home of the Guaranteed Sold program, or we'll buy it. I'm Adrian.
And I'm Attilio.
And if you have any questions, just give us a call at 799-9596 or check us out online at teamlally.com.
Hey, everybody. Our guest today has been a sales and marketing director with Copeland Insurance Group since the year 2000. The Copeland Insurance Group was started by Mel Copeland in Texas in 1962, with the Hawaii office opening up in 2010. Here today to talk about how Copeland Insurance Group can assist our seniors, 65-plus veterans, the disabled, and those with low income. Please welcome our guest, Margaret Wong.
Hello, Margaret.
Hello, everyone.
Hello. Welcome. Hello. Welcome to the show.
Thank you so much.
So Margaret, maybe you could share with us a little bit of, about, like, we did a nice intro for you, but, you know, how did you get to Hawaii?
Well, my family moved to Hawaii in 1960, mm-hmm. Grew up here, went to school, went to college, and then started working. And in 2010, I decided to change careers from travel and go into insurance. I helped businesses review their group insurance, and then later on decided to go into Medicare because I figure a lot of my business owners and their employees are turning 65, and there was a great market for them to understand because Medicare can be so confusing.
Hey, you kind of dodged a bullet there because you're going from travel to insurance. You did that. You must have had a really good crystal ball knowing that COVID would have such a big effect on the travel industry. So good job on that. And
all of the seniors, right? So we actually got connected with you, Margaret, through one of our clients who is an absolute raving fan of you and all the help that you've been able to provide her with, you know, navigating through this confusion of the healthcare and this all of the different plans and options and not really understanding what would be best. So maybe share with us a little bit about, like, those services that you do offer our seniors.
Well, we believe in really being customizing their needs mm-hmm. based on their individual doctors and medications if they're willing to disclose that personal information. Because what we want to do annually is to make sure they're in the plan that's going to be best for them that year. Because every year, everyone can make a change. Mm-hmm. So we do an annual review at no cost, no obligation. Because, again, we want to provide this as a service. I'm a senior, I'm in Medicare, and I know how confusing it is. So if I'm doing the research for myself, I want to make sure that all of our members understand what may be best for them. So we do these annual reviews, look up their medication, like their doctors, to ensure that they're in the plan that they're supposed to be on to maximize all the benefits that each of these various plans has and that they can customize it for their individual needs.
So it sounds like you really take a very personalized approach with each one of your clients?
We do. And that's why, like the client that referred me to you, Eileen, mm-hmm. she's been with me for over 10 years. And most of our members stay with us because of the fact that the amount of work that we provide them. And throughout the year, if they have a question on a bill or a doctor and I having some problems with their carriers, we will get involved because the provider is a very important part of our service, because if they're not happy and they're not being serviced, we will get involved since we represent so many members for the carriers. So we take care of the doctors as well as their patients.
Now, what does this cost the seniors? How does this, I mean, it sounds like a wonderful service. How much does this cost them?
Absolutely nothing. Because, again, seniors are on a fixed income.
Mm-hmm.
So we don't want to be charging them a service that we really should be providing, because we get paid by the insurance carriers.
Mm-hmm.
And because we are brokers and represent multiple carriers, we're not restricted to any one carrier. We do what's best for them. And because the insurance carriers are paying us, we feel that we're being well compensated. Therefore, we'll be at their call anytime, 365 days a year.
That's wonderful. What a great service, Margaret. Maybe you could share with our listeners an example of a success story and how you are able to save your clients, how much money you're able to save your client on a monthly basis.
Well, one of my very long-term clients was on they were realtors,
mm-hmm.
and they were on a group health insurance plan and was being charged around $900 a month per person, because as we all know, with this health insurance, it's all based on age. So as we get older, the cost of care is very expensive. So we really recommend for people when they turn 65, especially if they're owner of their business or they're self-employed, to give us a call so that we can help them understand that Medicare can be a very great option for them, because there are different plans and options with some that can cover 100% of all of their doctors and medications, all of their doctors and services, as long as it's an approved Medicare benefit.
So Margaret, with this particular client that was paying $800-$900 a month because their age, right? I think this was a realtor, mm-hmm. that you said he lived to 104.
Yes, he was.
How much money were you able to save him by kind of restructuring what he had set up?
Almost $500 per month.
Wow.
For he and his wife. So it is really quite significant. So that's what we try to do, because if you don't understand how to navigate the different rules and regulations,
mm-hmm.
and we are very compliant, because we want to make sure that whatever we recommend to our members, that it is a compliant way to do things and that it is within the Medicare rules and regulations.
Well, I think, too, I looked it up in the Guinness Book of World Records, and you are in there for working with the oldest realtor in Hawaii. It's official.
You know, he was an incredible gentleman,
yeah.
and so incredibly healthy. So we miss him, but again, he loved our services, and every year we look up their drugs, make sure they're on the right plan, and that's the service that we provide every single one of our members.
Awesome. Now, one of the things that you're doing to, obviously, you know, we're working with people that may be in that at-risk group for COVID. So you're offering phone consultations, Zoom consultations, things like that?
Yes, we do. Some clients like to see us face-to-face, but they're concerned about meeting us too close. So I actually drove to a client's home, drop off the information, called him over the phone and through my car and him at home. We went through page by page what they needed to understand, and we helped them with the enrollment itself. And we really want to get their family involved, because there's so many benefits that these plans include, that if they don't have somebody reminding them all these extra values, that it's not at no additional cost to them, that they can take advantage of that, because our whole goal is help them save money.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I was driving by one time. I saw Margaret. She, you know, her, she's so dedicated to her clients. She does drive-bys. she was sitting in her car. The client was on the stoop of the house, and they're like, "How's that package looking?" And the guy's like, "I have a question on this medic." No, and so, no, I'm just kidding. But the bottom line is that Margaret is willing to keep her clients safe and do whatever it takes to serve them. What we like about Margaret, right away we could tell that you're a person that's about the client first and make money second. Is that true?
I think absolutely. It is. Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. We feel that if our clients are happy, they're going to tell their friends and family. And that's how we grow our business. Because if a happy customer, like you all, you take care of your customers for life. Mm-hmm. And so every time they're happy, they're going to tell you their friends and family.
Yeah.
So,
and that's how we came to you.
That's right. So Margaret, we may have listeners that are, you know, from other states or other areas. Does your insurance group offer this service in other parts of the state or even of the United States?
Well, in actually 20 locations across the country. So I am somewhat of an expert for Hawaii. I'm constantly learning all the islands. But we have specialists and regional managers for each of these 20 locations. So as people move to the mainland, to Vegas, as in our good friends with Eileen, to Phoenix, I will contact my resources there and associates there. And we look up their exact location because we want someone that's going to be close by so that they're always just a phone call away and be able to know the plans in their specific service area. Because each of the plans are based on their zip code. So even here in Hawaii, between Hawaii, Honolulu, and those on the Big Island, the plans are very different, and each one has different needs and specifications. So we want to, again, make sure everyone has a plan that's going to give them the most benefit at the least amount of cost.
And you know what? And let's just speak to the listener that's most likely to be listening, and that's going to be somebody on the other islands. Because of today's technology and the skill sets and the capabilities that you have and the service you can provide, you can help anybody on any of the islands, anywhere in the state of Hawaii, correct?
Absolutely. However, I also have agents on the outer islands. So I always ask my client, if they want to work with me on the phone, I'm just a phone call away. But I always encourage them to work with somebody that lives on the island. Because again, you know, our kapunas like to work with somebody that's close by, that they feel that if they have a problem, that this agent will be able to go to their home if have to, or just always contact them. So again, we have agents that speak multilingual. I have agents that speak Ilocano, Tagalog, Korean, Chinese. So again, we want to do what's best for the member. If we don't have the language, we actually have translation services that are available to them.
You know, that says a lot about Margaret, that she's willing to make sure that the client gets better served by somebody on island face to face. You know, I Margaret, she even talked pigeon because I heard her. She's talking to the client. How do I get the Medicare, the kai? And she's like, yeah, we get the kai. We take care of you.
Absolutely.
She's very, very fluent in the pigeon. So, anything else?
I went to Stevenson. Thank you.
Yes, so Margaret, I'm sure that our listeners are going to want to know, like, what's the best way to get a hold of you or to learn a little bit more about your services and your company?
Yeah.
Well, the best way to reach us is call our office. Our telephone number here in Honolulu is 808-591-4877. 808-591-4877. That's the best way because we're always here, Monday through Friday, 8 to 4. So if they need anything, to give us a call, and we'll be able to return their call within the day or within 24 hours.
Nice.
And then the website is CopelandInsuranceGroup.com.
Yeah.
Yes, it is. And however, the website is excellent, but because you're representing 20 different locations, sometimes it's a little bit more confusing to navigate. So we just tell them, give us a call, but definitely check us out nationally.
Yeah. Okay. So you can check them out online at CopelandInsuranceGroup.com. And but you know what? You want that personal service? Just call Margaret. She's nice. She's not one of those scary insurance paper people. We promise. And you can reach her at 591-4877. Adrian.
All right. Well, thank you, Margaret, for calling in and being a guest. And we appreciate your time.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Mark. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
All right, again, that was Margaret Wong with Copeland Insurance Group. I'll give her a call for all of your questions with Medicare, and she will give you a VIP treatment.
Yeah. Who else we got, Adrian?
That's it. We've got about 10 minutes left in the show.
Okay.
So cool. I think that we can talk about the market. We can talk about open houses. Well, what do you want to talk about?
Let's finish off talking about what we started talking about in the beginning, which was the David Kiyosaki's cash flow quadrants.
All right.
Art Cecilio's random thoughts.
Mm-hmm.
And so 90% of the people, again, are where on that quadrant? 90% of the people in the United States?
They are on the left side, which was the self-employed and the employees. That's where 90% of the people are.
You either have a job or you own a job.
Mm-hmm.
And the other
90% of the wealth is on the other side, which is
the other side,
business owners and the investors.
Yeah. And you can be a combination, right?
Mm-hmm.
If you have enough passive income from your business, of course, you're either investing it back into your business or you're investing it and having that money work for you.
Mm-hmm.
One of the things that we came across, you know, this is not something new, but I wanted to hit upon more of that DST. Because I did have a conversation with a residential residential property owner yesterday, and we just went through the numbers.
Yeah.
You know, what we talked about is, okay, what kind of mortgage do you have? What's your mortgage payments on that? The second part is, what is the rent that you're collecting?
Mm-hmm.
So what is the what do we mean by positive cash flow, Adrian?
That's neutral? after all the expenses are paid out. Then what, you know, what's left over? So there's other things besides the mortgage and taxes. There's also vacancy, there's repairs. You know, as the property ages, there's going to be major repairs, right? So that's going to eat into your profits.
So let me ask you something, Adrian. So you had your rental property.
Yes.
And if the toilet blew up, who gets the call? It's you or your property manager, right?
Oh, yeah, my property manager. And it was my property manager was my mom.
It was your mom.
My mom.
Now,
thank goodness for mom.
Now, if the storage unit, which you have your equity invested in, and you're getting your $500 a month positive return, cash on cash, and somewhere between a 5% and 7% equity growth every year, do you or your mom get a call for the toilet being backed up at the storage unit?
No calls at all. The money just shows up in my account. It's
just
wonderful.
Shows up in your account.
My mom is happy too.
Nice.
Yes.
So that's what you want to have your objective, folks, because I don't know, whatever it is that you do for a living, you're trading time for dollars, and you got to ask yourself, do you want to be doing that when you're 98 years old?
No.
You know?
Well, maybe.
Maybe,
depends.
Depending on what you like, because you got to have something to do.
Kind of like Margaret's client that she had mentioned, the realtor that was 104. He was doing real estate up until he passed away because he enjoyed doing that.
Yeah,
connecting with people. Yes.
Kamehameha, when he got overthrown, or Queen Liliuokalani, when she got overthrown and kicked out of the Ilani Palace, she had to downsize. He actually helped her with a condo in Waikiki. No, that's not true. But anyway, the point being is that there are different ways to build wealth. And you got to ask yourself, in today's day and age, are you going to be doing it the same way that you've done it year after year? Adrian, what do we call it, doing the same thing year after year but expecting different results?
That would be insanity.
Insanity! And it's not a workout.
No.
No. It's like, I'll give you definitions of insanity. Adrian, have you been there? Have I been there? More month than money.
Yes, absolutely.
Where we have to be like, oh my
goodness.
I think
we all have been there.
Thank goodness for the kids. They don't need to know. We're having pancakes and Simon for dinner. They're like, yay, it's fun to them. But mom and dad was probably, you know, we were trying to stretch. We've been there. Trust me. When you stop thinking about money is when you have more in the account and you're not stretching and going month by month. So what are, you know, speaking of which, there's a career move that people could make that could get them into something that maybe makes a lot of money. It's called the poor man's company. What's it called? It's what we do.
Yes. So we do host a career night every other month. Our next one is coming up in March. It's the first Monday in March. If you go to HawaiiCareerNight.com, you can find out a little bit more about it and even sign up. Mark it down in your calendar. It's done via Zoom. So you can join us from wherever you're at, even if you're on a neighbor island in another state, and put your questions in. We'll answer them live. And we do have a presentation that we go through that hits on those questions that we get time over time from, you know, people that are exploring this career. So we would invite you to come join us for the next career night.
So market updates, you know, we are a real estate show. We should talk about real estate every once in a while on our real estate show. But the reason why, Adrian, why don't we talk about real estate like all the time, the whole hour?
Well, I mean, as exciting as it is, and people love to hear about the market and about, you know, homes and renovations and decorations, I think that, you know, there's only so much that we can talk about before we have to just talk about it again. So just we like the variety.
We like the variety. We want to come for contribution. Yeah. And, you know, in my opinion, talking about real estate for an hour, even though it's what I do for a living, that's boring. And, by the way, those of you watching on all the live streaming that we're doing right now, you're like, hey, Attilio, I know you're handsome, but you're not that good looking. Adrian's more pretty. We want to look at her. We're having some internet stability issues, so that's why I keep dropping her off of the streaming. So I'm not a StreamYard or a video conferencing hog. We're just having some technical difficulties.
And we've got about 2 minutes left, FYI. So let's get to the market updates.
Here's the market update. Median sale price for single-family homes wrapping up in December is, what's the number? I don't know if you can see it on there, Adrian. Can you see it on there?
$870,000.
Last month was $872,000. Back in October, $865,000. August, $839,000. July, $815,000. June dipped to $770,000. May, $797,000. And then April, $809,000. So kind of up, kind of down, but started at $809,000 at the peak of the pandemic, and we are still climbing up. So if you are a seller thinking about selling a home, it's not duck soup. It's not like shooting fish in a barrel. You're going to need a real estate team with a lot of resources that can help you. Tough negotiators, that's what we do. We squeeze every dollar out of the sale for you. And do we have a pretty good track record?
I would say it's one thing to get an offer, but then it's another thing to navigate your way through a success, through a successful escrow and closing. There's all sorts of things that can come up and do come up during that, you know, opening escrow to close.
Yeah, so. and we are seeing them. Good news is we've got solutions. And even if we come across something that we've never seen before, our mindset is everything is figure outable.
So and we figure it out together. We figure it out together.
Because our favorite website is figureitout.com.
That's right.
Yeah. So anyway, how much time we got left?
We got 1 minute left.
We got 1 minute left. Okay. A couple last things. We got open houses coming up.
Go to TeamLallyOpenHouse.com and check those out. Thanks for listening, and thank you to our sponsors.
And
Jody Tonga and Derek Tonga, Pacific Rim Mortgage.
And Bradley Bariama of Allstate Insurance.
Kenji Vendetta of Pillar to Post Home Inspections.
Janice Berlin with Dreamhouse Drafting.
John Speed of Kilauea Pest Control.
Duke Kim Han of Hawaii Pacific Property Management.
Kyle Shimoda of Impact Wealth Solutions.
Wendy Oshiro with Reverse Mortgages.
Robinson Villavera of Fine Line Paintworks.
James San Diego, Kanji Cleaning. If you want to get a hold of any of our sponsors, just go to TeamLally.com.
We also want to give a big thank you to Leah Rodriguez, our producer here in the studio. Make sure to tune in next week. We'll have an awesome guest talking about something that'll change your life
forever. This is the Team Lally Real Estate Show, home of the guaranteed
sold program. We can't sell your home at the agreed upon price and our time frame. We'll have it bought for cash. Be safe and aloha.
The preceding program was sponsored by Team Lally.